Hey coding owls, welcome back to my channel. In this video we are going to talk about a very important technology called as JSON. Now most probably you must have heard of JSON if you are a newcomer into the industry or into the IT thing. JSON might be a new thing for you. JSON is more like a mediator language. JSON actually helps multiple applications written in different languages to communicate with each other. Now there is a chance that let's say for example a company selling chocolates and a company accepting it. For example, let's say some mall like DMart or Big Bazaar want to buy the chocolates. Now they are not going to buy the chocolates in pack of 2 or 3 like we buy it on Amazon. They buy it in bulk. Now there is no chance that it's possibility that DMart whole system would be written in Java, whereas let's say Cadbury for that matter, their things were written in .NET. Now how will this they to communicate with each other? So normally they make use of something called as a microservice and that talk with JSON. Now the thing is how JSON is defined. Now JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation, is a lightweight data interchange format. So basically all the languages understand it. JSON is a mediator language like your expression. So no matter what you speak, either you speak English, either you speak French, either you speak German or Japanese, the thing is if you're happy, you're smiling. If you are crying, then you are sad probably. So JSON is more of a language like that. So in simple words, JSON is more like an expression in the world of programming languages. Now let us quickly look how JSON looks like. So as you can see on the screen, the structure of a JSON is quite simple. The whole JSON is embedded inside the curly braces and it's basically the combination of name and value pairs. Now when you talk about name and value pairs, the name is compulsorily a string, whereas a value can be of various different types. And you can see name and values are actually differentiated using a colon. And one JSON can have actually n number of key value pairs inside it, which are separated by a comma. The different type of data types in JSON are nothing but your string, number, boolean. You can have an object of JSON, you can have an array, or you can have simply just have a null value. So let us just pull up this example for now. And it's a simple JSON object. What it shows that the name is the key here, whereas the Sachin Tendulkar is nothing but your value. So in this particular scenario, you can see I have got three keys here. One is name, other is country, and third is my centuries. And centuries value is actually an integer value. A JSON object can actually have another JSON inside it. So for example, here I'm going to describe the detail of an employee, but I am also going to give the project and the manager. So it's going to be an internally and different object. So for example, employee has an project. So I'm going to show you what EMP ID 100, name, department. This all are nothing but my keys, but project is a key, but its value is nothing but a JSON object. And as you can see here, my salary is a floating value. A JSON can actually contain an array inside it. So how, for example, how will you create an array? A JSON array is depicted using a square bracket. So here in my detail, what I'm going to do, I'm going to take first name, last name, age. Now address is another JSON object inside the actual JSON, whereas a phone number of type home or fax is nothing but my value, which is basically inside a array. So phone number here is an array. So this is very simple to understand that how JSON looks like and what are the data types of JSON. And next video, we are going to understand how to work on JSON with using the Java codes. So thank you for watching the video, guys. Do subscribe to my channel for more exciting content.